truly independent senator in Philippine political history to win in national elections, not only once. Once was record-breaking enough, but we did it 4 times. No party, no money. We almost got declared as a nuisance candidate in 1995 when we first ran. I came out of the underground. I think I'm not sure if you're familiar with my history. 17 years as a soldier,
yes. Yes.
7 years as a rebel, and then 18 years as a senator. So I was planning to retire in 2019 when my term, which I earned in 2013, ends. But I think God wants to punish me some more for my sins, and he's put me in this interesting situation. I think a lot of our countrymen know us by name. So name recall, no problem. Awareness that we are running for the second highest position in the land, that's what we need to catch up on some more. So I'm trying to catch up on visibility and audibility, not so much to be visible or audible, but to introduce the program, the platform of the UNA, our children and our next generation of leaders and citizens. So our job, the job of our generation, is to help make the next generation of leaders and citizens smarter, healthier, stronger, happier, and safer. And you can dovetail from there. It covers every imaginable program of government which a responsible administration must undertake. Like, let's say, smarter education, K-12. Integrate a nutrition program between the ages of 0 to 6 para hindi underdeveloped bodies and underdeveloped minds, otherwise diminishing returns there. Stronger sports, recreation, safer, peace and order, happier, then you have a sense of nationhood. Because there must be harmony in the families, cooperation in the communities, inclusive growth in the state, order, and that would probably complete this much needed formula for national development. Long-term development. Audit says that I'm going to be his anti-crime czar. I will have to clear this up with him because I want to know exactly what it means. Because to me, if you're talking about anti-crime, I'd rather deal with it in a generic sense. No? Like peace and order, it's not something you relegate to policemen and soldiers only. No? Mm-hmm. Security, safety, protection. It has to be more encompassing. Like food security, job security, security from traffic. You get caught in traffic, you're an 8-to-5 laborer or office worker, you get penalized. Security of our OFWs, that's the short or medium term intervention, no? Protecting them wherever they are. There are 14 million of them scattered in 200 countries all over the world. But my dream, our vision, is to bring them all back home by generating job opportunities here that will not require them to leave our shores anymore. Because one principle, one guiding principle is that we have agreed on is no one is safe if some are left behind. In short, walang iwanan. We either get out of our poverty rut together, or we all stay together and fight and face the challenges together. Because my sad experience in Cagayandor during the presidential debate is the first question asked of the vice president, he was the first online, is he was asked to explain his properties. So I think that those were grounds for walking out, no? Because I think it's about platforms. You have to articulate your platforms, not explain your salin. So I'm surprised that it was even Comelec sponsored. So it shows you the degree of political immaturity even of our the mechanism for regulating what should be clean, credible, and free and honest elections. As you compete, as candidates, as leaders in the free market of vision, ideas, and leadership. If they did that to me, I would walk out.